50 feet in 15 minutes. That's how some folks describe the traffic where State Route 410 connects with Sumner and Puyallup. It's a bottleneck where the new meets the old. Sumner is your quintessential all-American town. Idyllic downtown with leisurely shopping, quiet neighborhoods with historic homes and churches, the bells and horns of trains rumbling by. But twice a day when commuters are on their way, Sumner feels more like LA.
There's just a lot more cars and a lot more people trying to get in and out of Sumner and into the train station and out of the train station.
And here's the culprit, a bottleneck of an overpass that's way past its prime.
That overpass was built when the freeway system was built, so 1967. And we looked quite a bit different in 1967, so that's a lot of new and different uses, all trying to use one very outdated overpass that was built at a different time.
This overpass connects Sumner's Traffic Avenue and Puyallup's East Main Street to State Route 410, a hunk of metal and concrete standing smack dab in the middle of explosive growth.
Bonnie Lake grew 600%. Puyallup grew, I think it's something like 200 to 300%. South Hill was nothing. I mean, it was farmlands, and I understand a restaurant called the Brown Cow. To Holly, that wasn't even on anybody's radar screen.
Over the years, Sumner has also become an important Sound transit stop with trains and buses serving thousands of riders, commuters who must navigate Traffic Avenue or Thompson Road on their way out of town.
Train riders and just general users of the area letting us know it took me 15 minutes to go about three blocks last night. Do something, please.
Sumner and Puyallup have done what they can, widening and updating their approaches to the 410. But the overpass belongs to the state, so WASDOT needs to join the party.
This one radiates into the two communities. It goes into Puyallup past Shaw Road. In Sumner, it goes up traffic past McClendon's. It winds around the bridge past the cannery, goes up Thompson Street past people's homes. So it's almost a hidden problem.
It certainly isn't hidden from the folks who regularly find themselves in this mess. And Sumner wants to share their frustrations. The city has launched a Twitter campaign at #SumTraffic. And the tweets are beginning to roll in. 15 minutes just shot of 410. Blah. Stuck in traffic again. Tired of sitting in traffic in Sumner? I know I am.
Clearly needs to be opened up to two more lanes. It would be awfully nice to have some pedestrian accommodations and some bicycle accommodations and a way for the bus to get through.
Unless we fix it, not only is all the money wasted and people idling and waiting to get through there, but the money that has already been invested on both sides of it to get people moving will also be somewhat wasted because it moved people a few more inches until they were stuck in the bottleneck.